that the Hindu deities were mythological, associated with these deities if they never existed.
You see, Kamal Bhai, I'm going to get a lot of stick for responding to you in an honest manner. You see, Vivekananda, even though he was highly elaborate, was also very magnanimous. He said repeatedly, people progress from where they are, not where you are. There are thousands and thousands, I would say millions of human beings who can only relate to the idea of religion through this kind of idea of focusing on some kind of, if you like, deities, some kind of personalities, whether it's Ganesh or whether it's Vishnu or Mother Goddess or Shiva or whatever. You see, human mind, being as it is, requires support or ability to focus itself. Now, you see, I can talk about Atman and Brahman, but it's so abstract. How do I actually turn it into real kind of thing which I can get my teeth into? If I go to a temple, celebrate a festival, have the idea of gods and goddesses in this colorful manner, then at least during that period of festivals or when I'm doing the worship, my mind gets focused because I'm fixated or I'm in love with these deities, these personalities. And Vivekananda recognized it. He said, we all require some kind of ploy to relate to the idea of spirit, because spirit is very abstract. So different Hindus, different people in different world have used different deities, whether it's Christ or whatever, to focus their mind to the idea of the spirit. And using that particular model, say that icon, if they can get focused, Vivekananda says, so be it. Nothing wrong with that. But he also said the following, this is what Kamal Bhai is on about. When you become mature enough, you don't need this. When that maturity arises within you naturally, that you feel this idea of worshipping a god in the temple is no longer suited to your temperament, it is time to walk away from it. But don't force other people to go away from it, because it's like this. These are his words. He said these are crutches we use to relate to the idea of the spirit. We require crutches, we are weak. So use crutches. If you are a disabled person, you require crutches to walk. So suppose I went around saying, I'm able, I can walk by myself. So all of you, I'm going to kick your crutches away. It'll be terrible, they'll fall over the place. Different human beings require different ploys, different methods to relate to idea of spirit. Vast majority are very fixated on idea of God like a personality. Vivekananda never said this wrong. In fact, he used to make fun. He said, I can never make fun of deities, because my mentor, Sri Ramakrishna, was singing the glory of Mother Goddess day and night, and I can't even tie shoelaces. It's so great. So this is the magnanimous nature of Hindu religion. It recognizes different level of progress. With some human beings, it is necessary to throw away the crutches. Look, I'm telling you my own example. If somebody says, which god do you believe in, Mr. Lakhani? In the primary school, children catch me out every time. Which god do you like, Mr. Lakhani? Ganesh, Hanuman, which one? And I say, my boy, the god I like is looking at me through your eyes now. You see, so if you like, my level of growth is that I cannot relate to God in the heaven. I cannot relate to a God who is like a deity. I can only relate to God who is looking out to the eyes of every human being I come across. I genuinely mean it. And the people can work out that it means business. So when I say not God in the heaven, not God in the temple, God in humanity. And this is the transition required for modern society. Because modern youth are fed up of God in heaven. They rather see God in human beings, interact honestly with other human beings, link up with other human beings. This is the right way of becoming truly spiritual, truly religious. This is a transition. We are in the process of transition now. In fact, Vijayabhai asked me sometimes, why are children, youngsters going to the temples? I said, because those days are over. They rather relate to other human beings and do whatever activity, secular activity, play badminton. They're happy with that. That's their way of relating to that, your spirit. So be it.